G'day Headbangers, thanks for joining us for another video interview here with Metal Ignition. Pato here, and tonight I'm joined by the boys from Vanna.
What's up, man?
Hello.
How's it going?
So they've been touring down the East Coast and through some regional areas on their own headline tour, and also you guys have supported Norma Jean.
Yep. Yeah.
A couple of gigs. How's that all been going for you?
Good. Norma Jean was great. It was crazy. It was like first time obviously playing over here, and there's a lot of kids that came out to see us, have been waiting to see us, I guess, for a couple of years now. And then I think we played to a lot of new kids, like a lot of Norma Jean fans.
Yep.
We got really, really good support on that tour. A band called Safe Hands and A Secret Death, which are amazing bands from Australia. So I think the total package made them like for really cool shows.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And you got the video out for Year of the Rat, so that's the single that's going on at the moment. I noticed there's the lyric video, and there's also a tour/live official video as well. Can you tell me about the choice to bring out two of those?
Well, the lyric video, I don't know, people do lyric videos now.
Yeah.
And I guess it's a cool idea and a cool concept, and someone at the label, the like art director there, had a really cool concept for it using the artwork of the record, so we're like, yeah, go for it, do it, it's cool, it won't cost us anything.
Yeah.
It'll be rad, and I think it gives the kids a chance to like dissect words and stuff like that before the record came out with the lyrics in it.
Yep.
And then the other video, the actual music video for it, is all kind of Sean's brainchild, and we wanted to do a video ourselves. We do a lot of things by ourselves.
Right.
Because I feel like every time we've got, a lot of times we've gone to like do stuff with other people or other things, they just don't have the exact same like, I don't know, vision that we have.
Yep.
And we know how to like cut corners and make things cheaper and all that other shit. So yeah, Sean did all the work for that video.
So how many shows worth of footage did it take to build up the video?
It's a whole tour, kind of, right?
Thinking back about it, it was like almost one whole half of that tour. So like we did the Midwest. The first show was in Chicago. We went all the way to the northwest, like Seattle area. We actually hit a show in Tacoma there that was a floor show that you can see in the video. And then down the coast. And the kind of idea behind it, like there's a couple like black and white plot shots, if you will, where like we start from home and we're crossing the country, playing these shows, doing all the behind the scenes stuff to get to this one show in LA. And then on the other hand, you have this kid waking up, you know, going through his daily life's activities and his journey just to like getting through the day just to get to that show.
Yeah.
And then when the two finally meet, that kind of like brings home the whole idea of the few and the far between the album, like being like the people that we've met on tour, the people that we've kind of considered friends and family that are like scattered about, and this music kind of collects us all together. So like that was kind of the idea behind it. Like, yes, it's a very like live video, but like the whole idea behind it kind of reflects the album as well.
So it begins again.
The last book of Twitter was based on a concept that kind of came up with that was just the view of our band's journey through music and the music industry through the eyes of like one person. And then this record is kind of like, you know, 10, 11 songs all having to deal with like things that I think all of, you know, us five have kind of like being, you know, older 20 something year olds have dealt with, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Like, you know, dealing with that, you know, that real shitty girlfriend, dealing with the absence of like fathers maybe in our lives, deal with the realization that like, you know, God's not present in our lives. It's kind of like sort of our little coming of age anthem to stuff. And I wanted to get more personal with this record. I think the last record was personal, just it was kind of more, you know, concept based like you said, but this one just way more direct and to the point. And very specifically, you know, about what we've gone through, and if we've gone through it, That means there's other kids in the middle of going through it, or have already gone through, people that are our age, or kids that haven't yet gone through it. Like, this happens. Like, you're not weird. You're not alone. This shit happens to all of us. So I guess that's the whole, like, that's the whole thing behind the whole record is, like, you know, we all suffer through this together, no matter, you know, who you are, you're going to go through this. You know? Or maybe you've gone through it and can relate to it. You know? Biggest thing for us is, like, we don't care about reviews, we don't listen to any of that shit. And the biggest thing for us is all of our friends were like, that's the record,
right?
That's it, that's what you guys have been trying to get.
And not kids, like, people our age, like, you know, like, maybe they've grown out of maybe buying all the new hardcore records as they come out, and yet they were the ones who were like, honestly, I haven't bought, like, a hardcore, I'm 30 and I haven't bought one, but, like, this is awesome, and I played in my car.
Yeah.
That was cool when, like, your good friends who are also now into it.
That's what kind of
that felt pretty cool.
This band has toured for 7+ years, and this has been this past year has been the most touring we ever done. I mean,
there was the best tour.
And the best touring, like, and good, like, tours,
quality tours and stuff. And I feel like we were not home. I feel like we missed the entire year at home, which is okay because we were on the road. And I think that, you know, it brought us together as a band. Musically, it stepped us up. I think for just in every aspect of our band, I think it brought us to a whole, like, you know, kind of different level. And I think that people, I mean, bands really, like, we'd meet up on a tour and people were like, how long have you been on tour? And, like, I think we toured total, I think it was, like, a little over 10 months the entire year. This year has been more international touring for us.
Yeah.
We're doing, you know, we just did a U.S. tour with Every Time I Die. And then now we're in Australia. We get home, we go to Europe and UK. And then when we get home after that, we're going to be doing another, possibly maybe some a little more international touring, but then another full US, and then maybe back to Europe again, so. I think the one band that we all really want to play with, which I don't think any of us ever played with, is Converge.
Yeah.
And they're from where we're from. We've never done, like, a fest or anything, so hopefully,
Deftones.
Cool. Hopefully, we'll get to do, like, some sort of one-off, and they'll play it. Everyone that did Soundwave this year is gonna play with, like, fucking Metallica and shit.
Yeah, yeah. There are some cool bands this summer in Europe that I'm kind of stoked about. I mean, it's not, like, crazy stuff, but we're on a bunch of those. We're doing, like, the whole festival circuit in Europe.
Yeah.
So even bands like Terror, like, we've never played with Terror. I mean, I've seen them, but, like, that's cool. We get to play with Terror. Like,
Terror.
We're gonna play with Harm's Way, Twitching Tongues, bands that we like, and.
Yeah.
It's cool to be with a bunch of bands that we're into and not just bands that you're supposed to be with. Or, you know, like, you know, maybe maybe we would never do a tour with a band like Twitching Tongues, or we maybe would never do a Harm's Way tour, or, like, I don't know. Well, there was a bunch of cool bands in there. But for those festivals, you know, we get to be with those bands and meet them and stuff, so pretty cool.
All right. Sweet. Cool. Well, I think that wraps it up. So have a good night and enjoy the rest of the touring in Australia, and make sure you get onto the Metal Ignition Facebook and hit Vanna up on their Facebook as well. Check out Year of the Rat if you haven't seen it yet, and stay metal, boys. Down the skies and make the bow to me. I am a young.